to make you alert, again we give a real example. What happened? There are some complaint that in some particular models, some cars, there is a engine jam, new engines. Now reason was not known, and what happened when you open the engine, you found that connecting rod bent or piston damage, connecting rod are just bended, or sometimes it is totally broken on road. Now then people analyzing, okay, what is the reason why connecting rod is bent? So, but the case was not solved. The root cause was, they say the section is weak, design part is this, that, but similar design on other car, that is not creating any problem. So again, after some times, we got the opportunity to work on this problem. So again, as I mentioned, that we feel that we should work on a 3G concept. 3G concept means go to the spot. So when I told them that, okay, whenever there is a case, we would like to see the vehicle. So we went there and we have analyzed the car. And then we have collected the data of past 5 years. You see how to solve the problem, any problem. You see the in which month we are getting the such type of failures. So we have started from January to December. Then in which area, whether it is from Jaipur, it is from Jammu, it is from Chandigarh, it is from Bangalore, it is from Delhi, from which area these failures are coming. I am discussing the systematic approach, right? So those data has been collected, and when you compile the data, if data is true, no, it speaks a lot of things. So data collection is one part, data analysis is another part. Like when you go to the doctor, like it is ECG or your heart, like they are taking, so you use that big slip, you know, even that X-ray. For you, if you will see that data, that graph, maybe meaningless, right? That heart pulses are coming, you can't judge what is happening, or you can judge. But doctor, when we'll see, okay, theek aapka, no, it is not. So that is a data analysis. You should have a knowledge. Your data speak, but you should be capable to understand what data say. So when we compile the data, two interesting things came up. One thing is that problem is much more only in gen model, not in other car. Number two, that problem is occurring only in the month of, maximum cases are in the month of July and August, not in January, not in February, not in November. You see how the data is telling you. Then you will be thinking, Rayar, kya hua? January mein koi problem nahi hai. Suppose there are 100 engines failure. January mein nahi hai. February mein maybe one. Or no. March no. April no. May maybe one. June maybe one. July 50. August 48. Then September reduces. It is this. So, you know, data is saying something. Right? Now question arises, why in June and July? Why? Any? Temperature?
All of a sudden temperature down in July. That is stresses, thermal stress. That may be, or there is stress, grain boundary stress. It may. Stress in next condition, there is stress portion, most concentrated stress, then further stress is given, that will break.
Humidity. Suppose I give this data, it is in front of you. Okay, sir, we have the cars coming in which this connecting rod is totally damaged. Any other? So anyway, we see that. So I got an idea immediately what was the reason, because of the mechanism and all these things. The reason was hydrolocking. Have you listened this word? Heard this word, hydrolocking?
Yes. The water through the air filter enters the
combustion chamber.
There is a water.
So what happened? July and August was our rainy season. Right? And in rainy season, you know, on Indian roads there is a lot of water logging. The vehicles are passing through the water. When they are, if water is supposed 3 feet high depth, so then clearance is not much. But when it comes, so the structure was, the air cleaner location was like that, the fan belt and all that, they are moving, right? And when it splashes the water, they are just entering the water into the intake side, they are throwing water. So water enters or waves comes and it flushes, the water is getting into the intake, and that water through the air cleaner spray foam, it enter into the combustion chamber. Combustion chamber clearance volume is around 32 cc, clearance volume. If suppose 15 cc has come as a water, 15 cc is blocked, you know, because water is not compressible. So it means your clearance volume has reduced from 32 cc to only 15 cc, 50% reduced. So when, and the movement will try to pressurize it, and the part which is weaker in the link, a connect crankshaft is very
robust,
piston is also able to stand. The most critical part is that connecting rod. So that connecting rod is bending. Then again you see one more interesting thing. This is okay, we have seen that when we went, I have seen that vehicle was, that all seat, everywhere water was there. It was possible. So the, which I was, what I was thinking, so that was confirmed. Like we have checked there. Because even the person who was sitting on the part, that all the seats are wet. And you can see the carpet and everything is flushed with water. Now when you open the engine, another thing comes, that only cylinder number 1 and 4, their connecting rod are bent, not 2 and 3. Now as an engineer, as a scientist, as a professor, as a researcher, as a PhD scholar, as a MS scholar, as an engineer, what you will think? Why cylinder number 1 and 4. So there are 100 cases, 98 cases that cylinder number 1 and 3 are bending, not 2 and 1 and 4, not 2 and 3. So how to tackle these problems? How to find out this? So these are the practical and in cases where you have to apply your knowledge, your experience, your fundamentals. Because knowledge or any weapon, only that is good which works at time. जैसे आपके पास revolver है, लड़ाई चल रही है और वो काम ही नहीं कर रहा, and you have a stone और वो काम कर रहा है, आपने मारा और वो बंदा जो आपको attack कर रहा था, he is, तो stone is successful at that time, not your pistol. So similarly, this is called situational knowledge. Under some circumstances, when the time is not there, how you react? Even when you are driving, suppose some persons are coming, so somebody is overtaking unexpectedly and you are running at a 120 km. So at that time, it is a matter of few milliseconds, how you react at 120, whether you apply brake or you put in down gear simultaneously, right? and you take any other measures, how you react, that will save you. And that situation, that is called situational decision making, and that is in flash of nanosecond. So similarly, these situations sometimes they force us to think, and they challenge our knowledge, and that's how experience counts. Who is more knowledgeable, who has faced more problems, right? Actually, in my opinion, knowledge problem is nothing but the learning opportunity. If you will not face, and here people, when a problem comes, oh, a problem aa gaya. Now yesterday I got a call, we have given a vehicle, we were one SX4, we are designing for a CNG injection system and all that. So that report came and they told me that NOx is high. They start, oh sir, kya ho gaya, we have put so much effort and all that, the problem hogi, gaadi fail hogi, we have lost 5 lakhs rupees, 3 lakhs, because each test cost around 3 lakhs rupees. And I go, don't worry, it is a learning opportunity. You try to learn why NOx has increased and how you can reduce it now. If this problem will not come, you will not learn how to reduce under that circumstances. So every problem is a learning opportunity. You agree or not?
Yes.
So we should welcome the problem, or we should unwelcome the problem?
Welcome
the problem. So problem aati hai, fir why we are helpless? We should be happy, na? But it's the other side. Whenever there is a problem, everybody starts and he feels sad, yaar problem ho gaya. And when the problem aati hai, I become happy. So there is one more opportunity to upgrade your
knowledge.
Now it is thinking only. If you think like that, you will be happy even under the problems. And if you are other way thinking, you will be unhappy when the problem, and problem, you can't say in your life that problem should not come. इसलिए कभी आप इवन when you are doing pray and all that, don't pray that मेरी जिंदगी में problem मत देना. Give me strength and knowledge and wisdom to tackle the problems, to solve the problems. So it is a mindset. अब ये पानी रखा हुआ है, ये देखो, है ना? अब now this is half full, half empty. अब ये भी कह सकते हैं यार ये तो आधा आधा खाली है. I am focusing on the empty part. But what I need is a quantity that is useful for me. Now empty is not useful for me. So I can think, यार आधा गिलास पानी है, ये मेरी प्यास बुझाए. और मैं झगड़ने लग जाऊँ, आपने आधा ही दिया मेरे को, आधा ही गिलास पानी दिया. And तो it is, this is a positive thinking, this is a negative thinking. And this is applicable in not only on professional life, even in personal life, social life, and even day-to-day life. So always keep your thinking positive, because when your mind is positive, it can give you the solution. When the mind is in negative state, it will not give the solution. That is again a problem. At least keep your mind in peace, balanced, calm under all circumstances. So by thinking problem, I, oh very good, yaar, now we will learn kaise aayi hai, let's see that. Nahi, ek aa gaya yaar problem aa gayi, engine ye ho gaya, ye ho gaya, uske marks nahi aaye, marks kam kyon aaye, kya aaye, kaun si problem thi, like that. So it is all matter of thinking. So this was a case why cylinder number 1 and 4 was bent. I think that I leave to you to think something so that you activate your neurons.
I have something on carbonless fuel technology also, like your CNG system, why temperature, but I don't know whether we have time. First I will cover the emissions part, emissions testing and driving cycle. So this we know, CO is limit is 1 gram per kilometer, HE 0.1, NOx 0.08. This table you know, but which I am going to tell you, that may be new for you. Now if this is the limit, this is the target,
if my car, I am doing the testing, if I got it 0.9, 0.09, 0.07, will that car is meeting the emissions or not?
Yes.
Huh?
Yes, sir.
No. Regulations say no. Because we consider 1.2 as a deterioration factor. It is just a borderline case. If you test it second time, it may go across the road. So your emissions minimum margin should be, it should be less than 20%. If it is less than 20%, even then the authority may ask you to test it three times. Second, if every time it is less than 20%, it is okay. That we call it V3 conditions. But suppose if I had designed a car whose emissions are 0.5, 0.05, 0.04, it is almost 50% there, this we call it V1. I need not to test again further. You will get the certificate, your car is okay. In first go itself, it is first. If I get in between 50 and 80, then I have to do the testing again two times. One and then one more repeat. And if it is less than 20, fail. Because repeatability, when we do the testing again, it should be repeatable. And you know, in emission technology, there are so many variables. Injector, you have the tolerance. Injector pulse width, it may be 4.3 millisecond, 4.32 millisecond also. Fuel quantity to be injected, is there any part without tolerance? Is there any part without tolerance? No part. So tolerance, when the tolerance will be there, next car you will fit the part. Injector nozzle size, suppose it is 0.08 mm, plus minus 0.01. So in one car, it may be 0.09 mm, in one car it may be 0.07. Both are right, because it is within the tolerance. But they will change the performance? No. Fuel injection pressure, suppose I am saying 3 bar. Exact 3 bar is not possible. Or is possible? There will be tolerance 3 point plus minus 1. So 2.9 to 3.1. So in one car, the setting and all that is like that 3.1 it is giving. In another car, it may be 2.9. If injection pressure is 2.9, it will inject less fuel. If it is 3.1, it will inject slightly more. So your strategy and mechanism is there, but it has to, how it respond, and that you have to see. Oxygen sensor. Again limit, minimum voltage 0.2, maximum 0.9, again tolerances. Response time, tolerances, each and every part has a tolerance. Now see how the complex is system. Are you able to analyze the complexity? It is very complex. And you know what we do to avoid this? When we are developing new car, we are launching new car for emissions, we have limit sample. One car we develop with the extreme limit sample, upper side tolerances. Another set we develop with the lower limit. One set car we develop with the middle limit. And all the three car we go for the testing. And then we see what is the level of fluctuation variation. And then we freeze that. And even preparing the limit sample itself is a challenge, because if I am making an injector has 40 parts and every part has a tolerance. No, spring is a tolerance, diameter is a tolerance,
solenoid valve current is passing through tolerance, wire which is used for the winding, that has a tolerance. No? You see the complexity. One limit sample, if normal injector is costing around say 1000 rupees, limit sample cost you 1 lakh rupees. Because you have to make specifically, that is in mass production, you are producing millions and millions, but one sample, अरे मेरे को स्प्रिंग साइज का देना, लोअर साइज का, ये मेरे को इसमें दे, ये यू हैव टू असेंबल दैट. एंड इन इंजन मैनेजमेंट सिस्टम लाइक दैट देर आर अराउंड 100 पार्ट्स, ऑल सेंसर्स, एयर टेम्परेचर सेंसर, कूलेंट टेम्परेचर सेंसर, मैप सेंसर, ऑक्सीजन सेंसर, क्रैंक पोजिशन सेंसर, स्पार्क प्लग. वन मोर इंटरेस्टिंग क्वेश्चन आई विल आस्क. Petrol engine is more stable. You have seen the when I am not doing anything. I am telling you start the engine. When you have diesel car, one petrol car. Start the engine and stand near the cars. Okay. If idling RPM, say we are saying 900, is engine is running at 900 RPM? Spec is 900. Is the engine is running 900 RPM? Can engine run exactly at 900 RPM constantly?
No.
No. It is 910, well, some variation is there. Similarly, diesel engine. Now, my question to you is, first question is, whether petrol engine will be more stable or diesel engine will be more stable? Question number one. Number two, what is the level of variation and what you fix as a acceptable criteria? Yes sir, isse jyada variation engine is not good, itna variation se jyada nahi hona chahiye. Now I am talking about only speed, nothing else, and that also only idling speed. You are doing this daily, I think, either you are sitting in the car or you are using the car or motorcycle, isn't it, or bus, trucks. Now this is my question. Is it interesting? Huh?
The diesel car is more stable.
Number one, diesel car is more stable. Okay, आप अभी तो यही करें कौन सी stable है? Let me get the answer. Your answer is diesel.
So petrol car is more
stable. Petrol is more stable. चलो टीम में हैं तो दोनों आएंगे, बिल्कुल आएंगे, ठीक बात है.
At
idling, petrol car is most stable. So, petrol ke do candidate ho gaye aapke yahan se,
ha? I am having diesel car, but I am in favor of petrol car at idling case.
Theek.
Petrol car is more stable.
Petrol car is engine is more stable at idling. Matlab fluctuations are less.
Because sir, at idling in petrol car, in cabin, we don't find any kind of vibrations.
You are misunderstood. Vibration is something else. Vibration will be more in diesel.
Yeah.
I am asking the idling speed stability. If engine idling RPM are 900, whether it is operating, that is you are understanding with the vibration.
Yes, sir.
The vibration is not the stable idle stability.
तो सर जब हम एक्सेलरेटर प्रेस ही नहीं कर रहे और वहां पे जो आरपीएम
हम कुछ नहीं कर रहे, मैं वही कहा, हम कुछ नहीं कर रहे, हमने तो इंजन स्टार्ट कर दिया और उसकी आइडलिंग कंपनी कहती है अभी 900 आरपीएम है इसके आइडल आरपीएम, जो भी है, तो वो 900 एग्जैक्ट, वो तो आपके जो इंस्ट्रूमेंट है वो दे आर नॉट एबल टू आंसर दिस क्वेश्चन. ठीक है, वो तो आपको एक डिजिटल वो चाहिए जो आपको बताएगा. अब उसमें तो आपके एनालॉग में तो 900 का 910 भी हो जाएगा, तो हाउ यू विल जज? 890 है, कैसे जज करोगे? मैं कहता हूं 898 है, विल यू बी एबल टू जज? नो. माय क्वेश्चन इज साइंटिफिक क्वेश्चन, इंजीनियरिंग क्वेश्चन, नॉट ए लेमैन क्वेश्चन. व्हेन आई एम डिजाइनिंग द इंजन, व्हाट आरपीएम फ्लक्चुएशन आई अलाउ, व्हाट टॉलरेंस यू कैन से, what tolerance I fix on the idling RPM.
at 900, suppose I am writing 900, idling RPM 900. So it is not possible to make me every engine or even one engine to remain constant at idling. Even I am not doing any changes. That will be my next question. If I am not changing anything, why there is a variation then? But we are not changing anything. All sensors are same, or are you changing the sensors? Fuel, whatever in the tank it is there, piston, rings, everything same, and you are outside. You are sitting there.
Some methods of carburation.
Carburation to hai nahi, injection system hai.
Mixing of air and petrol and otherwise injecting
the... नहीं, पहले तो पहले अब उस क्वेश्चन पे आई है, बाद क्वेश्चन है, पहले ये बताए पेट्रोल में स्टेबिलिटी है आइडल से भी कित, और डीजल में है?
डीजल
इज मोर स्टेबल.
आई वांट टू गिव सम आइडिया व्हिच मे और मे नॉट बी राइट, बट आई वांट टू गिव सम आइडिया
प्लीज.
I am Adarsh Kumar speaking from IIT Badal Engineering College. Answer to first question which is in my mind is, when we design the engine, every system having some mass moment of inertia, we are not changing the parameters due to eccentricity, or when we balance the system in a reciprocating system, we say it partially balanced. So that factor is in my mind that may be responsible for the fluctuation of the speed. Second thing is vibration will be more in, and we can say that variation in the speed will be more in diesel engine as compared to petrol engine, for which the reason may be compression and ignition of diesel.
Okay,
this may or may not be right.
Yeah, thank you.
My observation.
Yeah. Now, because we have short time, and now there are two things possible. Number one, I can leave this question to you and then you can answer through emails and all that exact. Number two, that I tell you the answer now. Okay, let me answer. In petrol engine, the fluctuations are more. If I fix a spec of 900, the variation are in the order of plus minus 30. It means your engine will go up to 870 and it may go up to 930. Even in catalog, we write up to plus minus 50 to be safer side. But actually it is plus minus 30, 35, that much variation is there in petrol engine. The engine will, sometime it may tell you 890, 920, next time 895, 902, 899, 901, variation may be 2 RPM also. But within a minute time you can see, we call it coefficient of variation, cyclic variations. What is that? And there is a specification for that. Okay. So I will not go into the detail. In diesel, the variation in RPM are maximum plus minus 5. If your RPM is fixed 800, so a diesel engine will not go above 805 and 795.
So due to heavy
fuel? This question I will leave to you. Why? Okay. I am telling the answer. Okay, then you can go deeply, right? Number one. Now, second thing, why? Why petrol is, there is a variability, why in diesel there is a? This I think you try to find out. If you are not a still query, my mail will be there. You can send the mail and we will discuss. So this is one thing. It means, now next question is, I am not changing anything. Even that mass balancing, flywheel, everything is fixed now. For that engine, it is constant or not? Whatever the specification is, that is for that engine, it is fixed. It is not going to change. Then the reason is why that you try to understand the reason why there is a fluctuation. Then you are sitting outside, just watching the engine. Tachometer is there, digital, and you can see, and you can acquire the data. You can see, you can plot this, and you can see how the engine tick 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 tick, or every time it is different. Every time. Why? Question to audience. Okay, to answer. I am starting my presentation.
So this year, that is the emission. Now again, important thing, emission regulation are different for the passenger cars, for the genset engine, off-road engines. Off-road engines are, here the emission norms are in gram per kilometer. Please note it down. It is gram per kilometer. If 1 kilometer vehicle travel, how much gram it will emit. In bus and trucks, it is not gram per kilometer. It is in gram per kilowatt hour. It is power based. And it is different. Tram 1, it is for the like off-road vehicles like that. In catalyst, I will just tell you that there are two types of catalyst, single layer and double layer for emissions control technology. And single layer, we have in one layer only, we use platinum rhodium. In double layer, in one layer we use, top layer is rhodium and bottom layer is platinum and rhodium. So now I will focus on the emissions testing basically. And
which one is preferred?
Huh?
Which one is preferred?
Same double layer, double layer for double better. Layer. You see, beside this emission, there is a regulation of evaporative emissions regulations. You see, well, there is a fuel tank. In the fuel tank, have you noticed when you are filling the fuel, lot of
gases
are coming out, vapors are coming out. Even in Sweden and Switzerland, this is the regulation. When you are filling, the gases cannot come out because that is going into the, and that is pure hydrocarbons. We are wasting, suppose, even 10 cc of petrol. Multiply that per day, per month, per year. So you can arrest that, you can avoid that. But that regulation is in India, it is not there. Another regulation, after filling, India is hot country. Petrol will evaporate. So earlier there was a vent, it is going to the atmosphere. Even now in motorcycle, it is going in the atmosphere only. There is no mechanism. But in the car, there is an evaporation emission control technology. You want to know this technology? Just this is tank, like from here, we take these vapors to a charcoal canister. This is the charcoal canister. Here it store all the, it absorb, not absorb, it absorb. It absorb the HC, and when another pipe is connected to the, this is going to the engine in the intake system. Under certain load and speed condition, these vapors are sent back to the engine. And there is a specific testing procedure for this. So this is also a regulation. So you should not emit more than 0.2 gram of fuel in the environment. So that test is there. Now how we do the testing? Now there are two procedures. Number one, for heavy duty vehicle, we do the testing on the engine dynamometer. For car, for mass emissions testing, we are putting the car into the chassis dynamometer. And while development,
First we do the baseline calibration at different load and different speed condition that I have shown you the lookup table for fuel injection. You optimize the duration of injection and ignition timing at each and every condition. You are changing load of combination and all that. Design of experiment you have to do. You may have to conduct maybe 1,000 experiments. Then you have to do the emissions testing first on engine dynamometer. Then performance, what is the power and torque characteristics, and then you have to go for the endurance testing. That my concept is running for 1,000 hours. Generally, before launching any vehicle, we do minimum testing of 50,000 kilometers. We actually run on the road 50,000 kilometers, and every engine is run, new engine, 1,000 hours. Then it is dismantled and checked that. So that is called, so there are three type of testing. One is the calibration testing, then performance testing, then endurance testing. Endurance testing is like we go for miles and miles, that we decide 50,000, 60,000, 80,000. Another important development, I don't know whether you are aware or not, till Euro 3 for vehicle, we are doing constant speed test. It means for diesel engines, for heavy duty, we are running the engine, suppose at 1000 RPM constantly at 25% load, at 2000 RPM 50% load, at 3000 RPM at 70% load, at 3800 at full load. So it means speed was constant, engine was running constantly at constant speed. Then you are taking the emissions. But that is not the actual condition. In actual condition, engine is intransient, speed is changing. What happened during that period? If engine is running at 2000, when it will increase to 3000, during that period, what is happening to the emissions? That is not captured. But Euro 4 say that you have to meet the emissions during transient time also. And that makes the things more complex. Even dynamometer, now we call the dynamometer transient dynamometer, which can respond the transient conditions. So constant speed, fuel constant, air constant, 1500 RPM I have to calibrate at one point only. In calibration, suppose when I am jumping from 2000 to 3000, it will take time and it will pass each and every speed 2100, 200, 300, even I say every one speed it will pass 2001, 2002, 2003, theoretically, right? And then it will have. So what is happening during all the entire range that you have to optimize? You can see how many number of points it will become. So it is a very complex task. Just little bit idea, when new vehicles are developed, first we do the base calibration, then we do the drivability test, whether vehicle is driving, ability is good, pickup is good, braking is good and all that. Then we do the cold weather test. You know, for every vehicle, at what temperature you may go to lay, their temperature may be suppose minus 30. So, you know, even there is a regulation. Startability. Have you seen startability test? Do you know startability test? Have you heard startability test? When suppose you purchase a car, and when you are starting the car, go in the old time when Fiat vroom, so you enjoy that, or you enjoy that kick tick, start tick start immediately. Or new start, new start, like that. So that is startability later on, right? Now, what we decide that startability should be in first crank, in first attempt only, number one. It should not reattempt, number one. In first attempt also, the cranking of the engine should not be more than for 1 second.
the engine should be able to fire within 1 second. Within 1 second. It may be 800 milliseconds, 600 milliseconds. Generally, we prefer less than 800 milliseconds. But 1 second means 1000 milliseconds is the upper limit. Okay, this is at this temperature, like you are in Chandigarh, it is okay. But if you go to Leh, then again you have to start at minus 30. Will the same test will be applicable or not? There, limit is same, 1000 millisecond, but you can make maximum 3 attempt. It is good if it you can start it first attempt, but if it is not able to start it first attempt, you can try second time. Worst case, you can try third time. But third time, it must start. If it is not starting, that vehicle is failed at minus 30 degrees Celsius. This is the startability testing. Now, startability also, cold startability and hot startability. Suppose you are running a car at 120 km. Then you stop. आपने सोचा यार कुछ चाय वगैरह पीते हैं, चाय पीने चले गए, चाय पी के वापस आए 5 मिनट के बाद. Do you know when your car is traveling, at that time your engine has some temperature, and after running, when you have parked the car, the temperature will go down or temperature will increase?
Rise.
So when you make the car standstill for few minutes initially, not always, for few minutes, maybe for 10 minutes, temperature will rise. And when you come back, and then you are starting the engine, that is known as hot startability test. When the temperature is in the engine is very high, at that time it may start, it may not start. Like carburetor, they are creating a lot of problems. So that is a hot startability test. So we have a cold startability test, normal startability, and hot startability. So all these three tests you have to conduct.
Then high altitude test. Then you go on the hills, there air density is low, whether you are able to start properly, what is the effect of the altitude, that you have to compensate. And then mass emissions test, of the, this is the last test. After all these tasks is passing, then we take the vehicle in the mass emissions lab. Anybody has seen mass emissions lab, chassis dynamometer? Mass emissions test, we drive the car under a certain driving pattern, and this is the driving cycle. What it means, you try to understand this. Here is mentioned, this is idling period, this one, right? Flat. This is the idling. Here I am starting, putting first gear, taking the vehicle speed around say 18 km, and keep here for some time, then decelerate, then idling. Then first gear, then second gear, keeping the speed around 35, second gear, then come down, then first gear 15, here I have changed the gear, second gear, I put third gear, take the speed 50 and keep the 50 km per hour for some seconds, that time is also defined. Actually, this graph will come on the computer screen, and you are, and when you are driving the car, then like this arrow will come, and it has to follow this. If your acceleration is more, it will go like this. If acceleration is less, it will go like this. And if there is an error, if it is not following, suppose here I have mentioned, okay, you have to drive at 50 km, but your speed has become 51. Or 52, that tolerance is there, plus minus 1%. If it goes beyond that, your test is not valid. That this we call it elementary cycle, first, second and third. And then like this we have to do three times, again same repetition, you see. Can you see? Same thing, right? So two, then third time again, one, two, three.
then again 1, 2, 3. So this cycle is known as elementary CT driving cycle, because in CT the vehicle is traveling like this. This is a assumption. This is a driving cycle, because how I do the testing. Actual driving cycle on the road may be different, but for the mass emission certification purpose, and this has been taken from the Europe basically. India has not designed their own, they have just followed it up from the Europe. It is European driving cycle. One difference is there. In India driving cycle, this is the hybrid driving cycle. This you have seen here, sometime for 70, then coming 50, then 70, and maximum speed is 90 km per hour. In Europe, instead of 90, it is 120. Because their roads are there. So our cycle is same as European, except this speed in the highway driving cycle is 90 as compared to 120. Now driving cycle is clear. So you have to put the car on the driving chassis dynamometer, and then you have to drive like this, and you have to take all dimensions in a bag, and then you have to analyze that. And this time is also, you can see here, this is a part one, we call a part two. So this is elementary urban cycle CT, and for each time is mentioned 40 second, 195 195 195 195, 400 seconds, and beginning of sample start here after 40 seconds. And this is the end of sampling, EA. So during this period, sample will be taken, and total driving period may be around 1220 seconds. So it may be around 20 minutes you have to drive. And then you collect all the emissions, then you measure that, what is the NOx, you can find out how much kilometer it has been covered, divided by the kilometers, and then you see whether, what is the level of CO in gram per kilometer, what is the level of HE in gram per kilometer, what is the level of NOx. Do you know CO2 is also coming as a regulation now? Abhi tak CO2 is not regulated na, CO2 to jitni marzi aaye nahi. Why? ਨਹੀਂ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਇਹ ਤਾਂ ਪਤਾ ਹੋਗਾ ਕਿ CO2 ਹੁਣ ਕੰਟਰੋਲ ਨਹੀਂ ਆਉਂਦੀ ਨਹੀਂ ਅਸੀਂ CO2 ਕੰਟਰੋਲ ਨਹੀਂ ਕਰਦੇ ਨਾ ਬਟ ਇਨ ਫਿਊਚਰ CO2 ਵਿਲ ਬੀ ਆਲਸੋ ਕੰਟਰੋਲਡ CO2 CO2 गाड़ी से CO2 कम आनी चाहिए ड्यू टू है, लेकिन वो कंट्रोल करना इट इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट टास्क. अभी क्या है, इट मीन इनडायरेक्टली यू आर आस्किंग द मैन्युफैक्चरर योर व्हीकल शुड बर्न वेरी लिटिल पेट्रोल. बिकॉज हाउ सपोज इन दिस कार व्हेन आई एम ड्राइविंग, आई एम गिविंग एन, इफ यू आर टेस्टिंग अ स्विफ्ट कार, इन दिस ड्राइविंग साइकिल the car is emitting 148 gram of CO2 per kilometer. 148 gram of CO2. Now, if I want, and limit is say 120 gram. So how you will reduce, and bigger the car, more will be the CO2. No, because it will consume more fuel. So for smaller car, it may be easier, but for 2 liter, 2.3 liter, because it is bigger engine, it will consume more, it will emit more CO2. So how to reduce the CO2? You burn less fuel. Less fuel means more fuel efficiency. It means your vehicle should travel in 1 kilometer, 40 kilometer or 30 kilometer, if the vehicle is now traveling 20 kilometer, because fuel economy is also coming in the cycle. We are measuring the fuel consumption also on this driving cycle. The value which is given in the
there, that is as per Brayton cycle sometime, or at constant speed. So that, suppose it is around 20 for Alto. So, and Alto is emitting 140 gram. So if to make it 120, the average should be maybe 25. The future is very, you know, challenging. You have to reduce, improve the efficiency. But one good thing, I tell you, if instead of petrol you are using CNG, your CO2 level will come down by 40%. The car, the Swift, which we have tested on the petrol and then on CNG, same car. There it was 148 and then it was only 102 gram. By 40-45 points it goes down, CO2. Do you know why? Because it is the carbon to hydrogen ratio of CNG. HC ratio of gasoline is much higher. The CNG, because there is a less carbon in the CNG, and that's why there is a trend we are moving towards. That's why I have some slide, but because of the time, we are moving towards the, if you go back 100 years before, solid fuel was being used, coal. Then we have switched from coal to liquid fuel in late 80s. 1892-93, people started inventing the diesel and petrol. So earlier only coal or wood, coal to liquid. Now liquid to, we are coming liquid to gas. Liquid to gas. In gas we started LPG, CNG, and coming to the hydrogen. And then we are going to pure energy form. From gas, so solid, liquid, gas, and pure energy. Now this is the actual lab where we are doing the testing. You can have a look. These are the roller. The vehicle is on the roller. This is the chassis dynamometer, and the force applied by this is actually which it will apply on the road. That conditions are simulated, and this is the fan. As the vehicle speed will increase, it will create the same airflow. You can feel if it is running at 100 km, so it will simulate the condition that air is coming at the same speed. And here I am driving the vehicle, and temperature is maintained in this cell around 25 degrees Celsius at the time of testing. So, and all the emissions, you can see the pipe in the back side. Here is the pipe, you see. This is connected to the tail pipe and it is taken to the emission measurement equipments. And there, as per that driving cycle, which I have shown you, during that driving cycle, all the sample is going for further processing, the imaging. Here the driver will sit and he will drive the car as per the driving cycle. Even if you are driving on this, you cannot drive as per the driving cycle. Either you will increase the speed because you cannot maintain the speed. Even you have experience of 20 years of driving, but you cannot drive on this chassis dynamometer in the beginning. Maybe after 1 week or 5 days some training, then you can drive. Accurately, you can drive, but what you will do? Here, you will cross this. Either you will, instead of 15, you make it 70, 16.5 or 13.5. Then retardation also, you will not follow this line. It may be out like that. Error will be introduced. So this is the, and it depends. The speed you can test up to, like here, up to 250 km. But it is for Germany basically, for Europe, because their limit is like that. And then standard temperature, here they are maintaining 20 degree, and there are chassis dynamometer where you can maintain minus 30 degree also, because suppose you have to do the lower temperature testing,
Then in Manesar, now recently there is a company, Denso Japan, they have put this chassis dynamometer, climatic chamber. They can maintain a temperature of minus 40 to plus 50 degrees Celsius on the site. But they need not to want to go on the hills and all, they have put the lab there only. And that cost maybe around 50 crore rupees, that lab. Otherwise, normal chassis dynamometer cost also around 20 crores. Now, drivability testing on chassis dynamometer, cold chamber, chassis dynamometer, high altitude chamber and with chassis dynamometer, we can simulate high chassis also, idling stability. This is the map table, which I am telling you have to do the calibration and all that. This I am just giving an idea. This is the duration of injection, RPM, and these are the, you have to change the values so that you can achieve the, this is the injection pulse width, 2 millisecond, 3 millisecond, 4 millisecond, 5 millisecond, and this is the multiplication factor. So it is at 2000 RPM, so 2.5 into 1.25, this will be the actual, you know, that is the how it works. This is online data acquisition. Now all these parameters, you know, different parameters, engine RPM, vehicle speed, lambda value, oxygen sensor, gas temperature, duration of injection, everything is displayed during the driving cycle so that you can analyze and you can see and you can improve. This is again a map table. These are different parameters, injection parameters. Suppose I see when it is coming, how much is the duration of injection. This is the gas temperature, gas pressure, gas pulse width, all these parameters you can display. And I think this is the RPM. You see, around 850 or so. This is the RPM. These are the mass emission results like CO. This I have done, I am just for your knowledge, I am giving you idea that we have done the test with CNG and hydrogen and CNG blended fuel. So I am giving a figure of CNG, like CO was reduced with hydrogen and CNG, red is hydrogen and CNG at 12 degree, then HC is also reduced, NOx is slightly increased with hydrogen, CNG blended, because hydrogen is more flammable and it has increased the temperature. CNG by CO2, you see, I was telling you, 107 gram per kilometer. And petrol may 147 gram per kilometer. You see, I have not done anything. But CO2 level has been reduced from 147 to 107 by changing from petrol to CNG. So that is a big advantage of CNG.
Any question from the participant side?
Regeneration.
Oh, regeneration. Regeneration is like this. That whenever there is a particulate matter in the exhaust system, we cannot allow it directly into the atmosphere. So we are storing it in the diesel particulate filter, and then it is oxidized. So oxidation of the stored PM is called regeneration. So that back pressure should not increase and it can accumulate, because the capacity, there is a capacity of particulate matter which it can hold. Suppose it can hold only 10 gram. So after 10 gram it will choke. So the engine will stall or performance will deteriorate. To regenerate that, you have to burn it off. You have to oxidize that. And that we do through the active regeneration system or passive regeneration system.
Okay. Thank you.